Hey guys, Thunder E here, and I have the Poco F3 with me right here. This device is what I consider probably the best gaming smartphone on the market, especially its price point at $350. So the Poco F3 here is a device that comes in at 6.7 inches display wise, and it's got 120 hertz display. It is a lovely looking display we have here in terms of just form and functionality. Of course, you've got the 48 megapixel camera at the back. We'll touch a bit about the camera and the camera functionality here. I don't like the extra fingerprintness of the device. As you can see, it's really shiny look, but it's a 5G device, so you've got 5G connectivity on the chipset here. So when you look at the Poco F3, there's a lot that is packed in that a lot of people will definitely like. So as I mentioned, this comes in with a 6.6 inch display, 68 gigs of RAM. You've got Invincible here. Honestly, go check out this on Amazon Video. This is an awesome show, a great comic book to read, but an awesome show as well. So definitely check out Invincible. And it's got a 4,520 milliamp battery with that here. So really nice, really solid device all the way through in terms of functionality, but we care about gaming and what we kind of get from gaming on this device. So the one thing you know is that, you know, since the Poco line follows the Xiaomi line here, you do also have that, you know, game center, if you will, where you have all your games. You can go ahead and check out all the games in there. So you can put in all your games. I've got Genshin, PUBG Mobile. There are a few games that kind of come with it that I really don't care about, but it tells you what your CPU and GPU are currently running at this time. And when you get into a gaming set, you can actually open it up and read your gaming performance. Now, some of you ask me, Thunder E, what about benchmark performance of this? For whatever reason, I still can't get benchmarks of any of the Poco phones, either the F3 or the Poco X3 Pro. I did run Geekbenchmark, and while it initially runs, it doesn't give me any results. So it would actually start off like this. And once it's done, you don't get any results whatsoever. So I've run a couple of benchmarks and there's nothing to show for it. So I really can't give you a taste here of what the benchmark actually does for this device. And I also cannot use my benchmark tool, Gamebench. It just won't work with it for whatever reason. Anyway, performance-wise, gaming, because that's what you guys came here for. So, you know, we went out and checked out all the games that we usually like to play. Call of Duty Mobile is one of the first ones. I'm going to open it up here. And the Game Turbo is quickly accessed there on the top. Gives you your CPU, GPU performance, and of course, FPS. But Call of Duty Mobile runs really well on this device. It runs at its highest setting that you can expect, which is really nice to see. On this, so even if you have an 870 device, it runs like a 888 device as well. So that is actually good, and you know, that kind of performance is great because you're not spending the same amount of money as a 888. So you know, you look at the settings for stuff like this, it works well, and which is good. Now when we go over to a game like PUBG, where we've got numerous settings that we can play with, that's where some people might think, okay, this is where this will also falter. So in PUBG, you can play at Ultra HD Ultra. You can also play at Smooth Extreme. Any of these two levels, it's quite easy to actually play games on there. And performance-wise, it also matches as well. So you're looking at gaming at Ultra HD, 40 frames per second for the full match, playing, you know, PUBG, and playing you know, games at Smooth Extreme, I'm getting about 60 frames per second for the full match. Maybe dip down to about 50 or 59 here or there, but you know, again, 60, which is really good to see on this device. So I can tell you that I can play on PUBG at the settings I like for whatever, you know, function, and it works absolutely well. So that's good. Now let's go to the game that of course is the benchmark hog for all games here, which is Genshin Impact. So Genshin is a game that we play at its maximum settings, 60 FPS for what you can do with Genshin. Have the settings on screen for you to check out. And Genshin, at least playing for the first 10 to 15 minutes, was able to keep it at 60 FPS. Now, I haven't really gone into much longer gameplay, I would admit. I do notice that it was dipping at certain points. So if I actually had a proper benchmark tool, you'd probably see that average of about 55 or so, similar to what you get with the 888. So performance-wise, it does match to your 888 devices, which is nice to see. So you can play the games you want to play. You can go in and enjoy those games and you get a very good experience altogether. Now, in terms of temperatures, which is what you guys are waiting to see, we got about 46 to 47 degrees Celsius, which is about 116 degrees, which is reminiscent of playing Genshin at this high temperature. So again, the new 800 series runs rather warm in comparison. That's just something to let you guys know. And the speaker is also decent, speaker quality pickup altogether. I think you guys would definitely like it while you're gaming or even watching video. Now, when it comes to images though, the images on the camera are decent at best. It's nothing mind-blowing. The camera itself has some interesting functionality, of course. Photo going to video, you can shoot video 4K 30 frames, which is nice. The front-facing camera can only do 1080p 30. But the images are basic and okay. Again, it doesn't really focus on that, but the performance on this device is really good. And if you're looking for something that performs well, has a decent battery and is 5G capable, the Poco F3 will probably suit that quite well. So let me know what you guys think. If you like this video, want to see more videos like this. Otherwise, guys, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and always enjoy your entertainment. Also, I'll leave this wallpaper for you guys in the description of the video. And definitely head to Board at Work because I do have my giveaway for the OnePlus 9 Pro going on. So go ahead and subscribe to Board at Work, Board Gamer, Board Femme, Board Shorts. Leave a comment and as well as your Twitter, Instagram handle to enter.